Shalom, Israel. All praise to Yahweh, Baal Shem, Yahweh Shai. Then Yahweh is the Father. Yahweh Shai is the Son. Baal Shem is in the name of. So, all praise to Yahweh, Baal Shem, Yahweh Shai. Double honor to the apostles that rule well. Much love to you, brothers, out there preaching the truth and sincerity. So, today I'm making this video because this situation I was in this morning is around some of my folks or whatever. People and just noticing, man, they got this new little craze or whatever. I mean, this is not the new craze. The new craze is this here, let me pull it up here. It's this Korean trap thing, you know. For all people who already know about the confusion of faces and all that, we already know that these ain't really no surprise. These little different people are you know, that could be Israel. You know, you see that little creepy face? Look at that. This is going to bring up the point that I want to make. I don't really want to jam it too loud because I don't want to get copyright stricken. Look at that. Look at those demon faces. Look at that. Look at that symbol. They don't hide this stuff. You know what I'm saying? I want to pause real quick. Now, you know, Don't get me confused, you guys. You know what I'm saying? The reason I'm bringing this up is because, you know, not to get too deep into this whole symbolism thing, you know what I'm saying? Because like the scripture say, I believe, let me find it, no curse against Jacob. You know, curse or something like that. Yeah, there's no divination. Let me just get the action. Enchantment, that's what it is. So don't get me confused thinking that, you know what I'm saying, all this stuff gonna really bother those people who the Most High is protecting. Surely there's no enchantment against Jacob, neither is there any divination against Israel. According to this time, it shall be said of Jacob and Israel, what hath God wrought? All right, so, you know, don't get me confused and getting all mystical and thinking that this stuff is just gonna really do something to people, but it's gonna bring a point. You know, when I first got into you know, the truth of this world, the underlying truth of this world, you know what I'm saying, one of the first things I ran into was the Illuminati symbolism in music, you know what I'm saying? And you know, it's still going on to this day, and this was a big thing that I saw. You know, Korean pop, and Korea's real heavy, you know what I'm saying? Matter of fact, let me see if I can get that. Korea's real heavy. Now, see, I might be wrong as far as the words. Let me see. I forget what exactly it says, but there's basically a scripture that says that Moab tried to be like Edom. But anyway, there's a scripture. If one of you brothers could find it, if anybody watched the video, if you could drop it in the comment section, I would appreciate that. Because that boy, let's see here, say. Bear with me, brothers. I'm just going to look this up real quick. And if this ain't it, then I ain't going to worry about it. Yeah, it's probably just the same one I was just saying, ain't it? Yeah, but either way, Moab tried to make himself Moab, which is these different little Asians and stuff, you know what I'm saying? They try to make themselves to be like Edom, And you can see it all through their music. You know, the same stuff that the Edomites make, the hip hop artists put in their stuff, the little all seeing eye, these little different satanic symbolism, this little affection that they have for death. They make these Koreans put the same symbolism in their stuff. You know what I'm saying? It'll be all over their videos, man. It be in their music sounds satanic. Look at that. Look at all this stuff. You know what I'm saying? Man, you know, ain't no incantation against Jacob, so ain't worried about all this stuff flashing across the screen. But I mean, look at that shit. Look at this shit. Like, what's the point in all this shit? You know what I'm saying? They getting blatant with this shit, man. Upside down triangle. Like, it really makes no sense. Let me not get a copyright strike trying to play this stuff, but you know, this stuff is everywhere, man. And that was just a little example. So, you know, like the brothers like to say, you know, they could be Jakes. But look what they doing, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know what this is. Let me just click on this, man. Rich Chigga. I guess Chigga is a Chinese nigga or something. Matter of fact, if I put it on slow, might not really. You put it on a slower speed. Hello. Well, you know, it ain't too much in this one because it's more of a just walk around type of video. But as you can see, he throw up them little horns of Mendez. You know, they got to do this stuff, man. Just like if they was down here, man. The point I'm getting at, though, is, you know, I just noticed this morning. Excuse me. I know it's been a long time getting to the point. But I just noticed this morning, you know what I'm saying? There's the whole feeling in the car, just the whole feeling, the whole mood was just on some old, you know, some old cold hearted stuff. I know the Most High said he was gonna make it like that. You know what I'm saying? He was gonna divide people. You know what I'm saying? People's gonna be at odds with each other. But it just seemed like, you know, it seemed like it was being perpetuated through the music that was playing in the car. You know what I'm saying? Like the whole mood just was being driven by this evil ass music that we just had playing in the background. You know what I'm saying? And you know, it's not even like no incantation type of stuff. It was just more so of the type of words, the feeling of the music that was coming out and all of that just seemed to really be driving the mood in the car. You know what I'm saying? And it was like, I could see it happening. And it just made me sick, man. It was just like, why do you even listen to this stuff? You know what I'm saying? Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and pull up a scripture, man. So this is 1 Corinthians 15:33. Be not deceived. Evil communications corrupt good manners. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, yeah, there's no incantation against Jacob. You know what I'm saying? No divination against Israel. But be not deceived. Evil communication does corrupt good manners. You know what I'm saying? And that's what was going on in that particular car ride. You know what I'm saying? It was that evil communication that was coming out. And just the whole idea of ingraining yourself and allowing yourself to get lost in that music to the point where you just jamming out to it. You just throwing up the hand signs. You just doing what your flesh feels like doing when you start hearing that music. If that music is being influenced by the devil, you basically dancing to Satan's tune. You piping to his tune. You know what I'm saying? I noticed that certain stuff start happening, throwing up the horn of Mendez as a secondary, as a subconscious type of thing. Now you're throwing up the horn of Mendez. You know what I'm saying? And carnal Jakes don't even realize what they're doing. They just start throwing stuff up, and then, you know, and it's like, bruh, You don't realize what you're doing. You're getting caught up into that spirit, man. You allowing yourself to be played like a puppet on the string because you're sitting up here caught up all deep in that spirit, you know what I'm saying, of this so-called Korean trap music, you know what I'm saying? Next thing you know, you at odds with everybody else and you feel justified in what you got going on. But it's like, bruh, ain't nobody trying to do you no type of wrong, you know what I'm saying? You just, like, you tripping, man, you know? And this is talking about when people be doing, like, little videos and stuff, and they be doing profane and they vain babblings. But this can also go for music too, you know. Shun profane and vain babblings, for they will increase unto more ungodliness, and their word will eat as doth a canker, of whom is Hymenaeus and Philetus. And I need to, you know, do some more research on that Hymenaeus and Philetus, but this is pretty much plain right here. Shun and profane babblings, for they will increase unto more ungodliness, and their word will eat as doth a canker. You know what I'm saying? The brothers Adam Abbott was coming out with a video not too long ago, you know, talking about how we should meditate on the scriptures. But carnal jakes, you know, and even some of us in Israel might be guilty of this. If a certain song keep coming on, you might be at work, you hear a certain song, you might be in the car, jamming the radio, certain song come on. That thing start eating as a canker, man. That thing start eating like cancer, too. You know what I'm saying? Like it'll seep down into your brain, man. Next thing you know, you humming that thing. You know what I'm saying? Next thing you know, you just sitting there singing it. And you just like, bruh, like, why am I singing this song? You know, it happened to me before. Like when that little song came out, I ain't even gonna sing it, but that little song from Lil Uzi Vert, the little XO Tour Life or whatever, man, when that song came out, it was like it was really just the beat, you know what I'm saying? And it just seeped into your brain once you hear it so many times. Next thing you know, you humming it or you singing it, and then you have to really stay away from it for like a couple days before, or even maybe a week or two before you even stop singing it, you know what I'm saying? Because once you hear it again, it's back in your brain. You know what I'm saying? And so that's what it is, man. Them words will eat as doth a canker, man. You know, you listen to that stuff, you got to shun these things, because if you don't, it gets inside of your brain. Next thing you know, you humming it, you living that life. You getting caught up in that feeling that comes with that stuff. You know what I'm saying? And I didn't really have a whole bunch of scriptures to go with it. You know, it was just a couple of things. You know, his tattoo says Illuminati. That's interesting. And like I said, it was just a couple of things, you know, that I want to bring out. But, you know, they're like I said, man, they're not hiding this stuff, man. They're not hiding none of this stuff. This stuff comes out, man. Mind control. And, you know, America have made all the nations drunk with their philosophies, the whore of Babylon. They all drunk off of the wine of this place, you know? And look at all this stuff. Look at our dollar bill, you know? This stuff is everywhere, man. This stuff is all throughout the media. You know what I'm saying? And knowing that these places have drunk of that wine, you know, it shouldn't be no surprise when you go to Revelation. See if I can remember. I used to bring this scripture out all the time. See if I can remember where it is. Yeah. Revelation 11 and 8. And their dead body shall lie in the street of the great city. What's the great city, man? I mean, if you want to be technical, New York City, but it's the whole place. The great city, which spiritually is called Sodom and Egypt, where also our Lord was slain or crucified. Excuse me, I got the hiccup. And, you know, that's spiritually, man, spiritually, where he was crucified, spiritually. But this place is like Sodom and Egypt. Look at this, man. These symbolisms are everywhere, man. The all-seeing eye. You just see it everywhere, bro. You see it everywhere, bro. Boom. Look at that. Boom. Dollar bill. What's that in the middle? Oh, man, look like an all-seeing eye, don't it? Dang. You know? This stuff don't happen by coincidence, man. Matter of fact, take it a step further. What's one of the biggest teams? What's one of the biggest teams on football, bro? The Star, the Cowboys, bro. There's a lot of occult ties to Dallas. Really, though, I mean, you probably ain't gonna find it just typing in something like that. But you know, me being from Dallas, man, it ain't no surprise that every team that come from Dallas pretty much got a star in it. You know what I'm saying? Dallas Cowboys star. Mavericks don't necessarily got a star, though they do got that M right there. I mean, they could stand for anything. Maverick, Mendez, could stand for anything. The Stars, the hockey team, got a star. No surprise. What's this FC thing? I don't even know what this is. Soccer club? Well, they go to star again. I mean, I know it's the Lone Star State, but good googly moogly, man. How many stars you going to have, man? You know? Also, let me see if I can find it on here first. Masonic Lodge, Dallas, Texas. If I'm not mistaken, the first Masonic Lodge was built in Dallas, Texas. Of course, they're not going to show you all this stuff. Well, anyway, which is a lot of things. A lot of things. Look, they got Jake up here bottled in a mud sucker. I don't even want to get too deep in this, but you know, whatever, man. We know about Masons. They go their eye again. What's so important about that eye, man? Why is that everywhere, man? Anyway, this place is spiritually called Sodom and Egypt, man. The great city, man. All this stuff is patterned after all of this. All this Egyptian, the worship of the Egyptian gods. And why is it so important that people keep on doing all this? What's so fancy about an eyebrow? Why everybody got eye chains on? You know? What's the point? All seeing eye pyramid. Why is all this? Why is this stuff so popular? The upside down pentagram. There you go again. What's so important about this star? He got a pentagram in his eye. You know, I mean, this stuff can get a little monotonous, man. A little excessive. You know, people start looking crazy when they start pointing stuff out like this. But you know, why is this stuff so, why is this stuff everywhere, man? What's the importance? Why everybody all of a sudden look like they have blood or something? You know? What's she doing throwing up some blood stuff? She never came out like she was in a gang. But why is she throwing up gang symbols? Is everything okay? Is that what she's saying? We know Drake ain't no blood. But what he doing? You know? What's this guy doing? Maybe he's a blood. No, maybe this white girl's a blood too, huh? Maybe Justin Timberlake's a blood too. I mean, and it says magic right here. Well, you know. Horns of Mendez. You know, we're not ignorant of Satan's devices, man. Even MJ had to throw it up, man. He had to give his reverence. These Korean stars got to do the same stuff, man. What they doing it for? You know what I'm saying? They're such menial. They're such small symbols. They're such small gestures. What's the point in even, you know, this stuff even being promoted? What's the point? What's the point, man? What's the point in people paying attention so much to these little symbols that they start emulating them? Oh, man, that reminds me, yo. Watch this, yo. Matter of fact, this will be the last video I pull up, man. And y'all bear with me if you can, you know what I'm saying? I know this probably look a little, you know, weird or whatever. Now, nobody else, it seems like nobody else really sees what I see when I look at this video, man. I haven't really talked to many people about it, but if you look at this video, this brother right here look like, matter of fact, it looked like he in front of a green screen. Look at the green around his head. But he's definitely in front of a green screen. That's the first thing. Also, don't be winking. The man that winketh, let's find that. Now be careful if a man feel comfortable with winking. He that winketh with the eye causeth sorrow, but a prating fool shall fall. What's prating mean? Talk foolishly or tediously about something. That's what a lot of these rappers and these singers do. Anyway, don't be smiling and winking at me. But yeah, man, just watch this video, man. I just want to point a couple things out. I'm not going to cut the music on because, you know, I mean, it's slowed down, so I could probably get away with it. He look uncomfortable, yo. He's in front of a green screen. So he's obviously got people around him. You can see the green outline around his head. That's what happens with a green screen. Look at that. Look at that. Even in these older songs. You go to Red Glove, the Scarlet Whore. What made her? He's paying attention to only that hand. This one's already touching him as well. And this one seems to be throwing up the same thing. But he makes it sure that he looks at that particular hand that's throwing up the horn to Mendez. They don't even look natural. Look at that. How you go from this position, let me fold up my stuff. That wasn't a natural gesture. Now I'm going to throw up the horns. Look at this hand. Horn of Mendez. Here go it again. It did it briefly over here too. Yeah, here go my nice little red gloves. Pay attention to this brother's eyes. He's going to keep looking this way. All right. Oh, did he throw it up? Kinda. You know. Standing when you need love. Let me go back though. I'm paying attention to him, but look at his eye. Look, you see him? You see him cut to the right? I know I'm being a little too in-depth with this, you know what I'm saying? But it's just something that I always notice. I don't want to miss nothing, but if I'm gonna look at his hands, y'all pay attention to his eyes. He gonna keep looking to our right, his left. He's going to keep doing it the whole thing. I'm going to pay attention to when he throws up them devil horns. But he keeps on looking right to make sure they know what he's doing. He's like, yeah, y'all see me? He's throwing up the little horn for a second there. He's throwing it up low. I think they, at the Y, they're going to tell him, hey, look, man, you need to throw that up higher, man. You ain't throwing them horns up high enough, bro. Look. You got to do it. No, let me do it again. Yeah, I'm going to bring it a little higher, let you see it. Oh, yeah, let me hold my hand like that again. Hopefully he get to it a little faster. There's one particular. But yeah, if y'all paying attention to his eyes, I'm looking at his hand. But if y'all seen his eyes, man, he keep on looking to the right, to our right, his left, to make sure that the people that's overseeing this video is satisfied. This probably take number 7, man. Take number 15. You never know, man. They keep throwing that up subconsciously. I don't even think it's subconscious. Now wait up. Guess I'll let it play. I think it's around here. I don't want to get no copyright strike. Hold on. Okay, see? Now, this is the part I wanted to get to. This is where he had to actually do it. Now, if you know anything about, let me see here. See if I can find it real quick. This will be the last thing, man. Y'all excuse me. Because I know it's probably been a little boring just sitting here looking at this thing right here. All right, so sun worship, Egypt. Now, if I'm not mistaken, I think Ra, quote unquote, is the sun, quote unquote, God. See, all right. So, look what he says when he does it. Daylight. He says, daylight, sun worship. Let me throw up these whatchamacallits real quick. And they call Lucifer son of the morning, if I'm not mistaken. Morning star. So we ain't talking about that. Now thou art fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning. Thou art cut down to the ground, which did weaken the nation. Why does this one say, son of the dawn? Look like they done elaborated on this mug in a different one. In this one, they try to go ahead and call him son of the dawn. Oh, shining one, son of the dawn. Oh, yeah, that's what y'all do in these other Bibles? You thought yourself most glorious as it were placed in heaven for the morning star that goes before the sun. It goes before the sun. Anyway, I ain't finna go down deep into that stuff, man, but even in these older songs, did I skip it already? Oh, yeah. It's right here. I guess I missed the first one, but anyway, y'all saw it earlier, man. When he said the daylight part, he had to make sure he threw up them horns, and also, if you just watch that video on your own time, man, you'll see that something ain't right. Brother keep looking out to the side and making sure that the people who directing that video, he making sure that he throw up them symbols, man. And then he trying to make himself, man. It just don't look normal, man. It don't look natural, man. It don't look like a natural situation, man. Like he really there because he wanna be there, man. Anyway. Y'all excuse me, man. I started off this video and I ain't gonna lie to you, I was a little aggravated. And just wanted to get some stuff off my chest as far as that was concerned. And as far as our people listening to this music, man, because this stuff do corrupt your brain, man. You know, whether or not it's an incantation on you, you feeding into your flesh when you listen to these things. And sometimes that can corrupt you and make you do something that you shouldn't do, man. It could take you out of your character, or maybe it'll put you in the character of what your flesh is, you know what I'm saying, which is against the spirit. And so, you know, we got to be careful about what we feed our brains, you know, what we feed our temper, man, you know what I'm saying. Out of the abundance of the heart do the mouth speak, you know what I'm saying. If you listen to this stuff and it's in your heart, which is your mind, which we all know, la'ab, if you letting this stuff get into your mind, then you're going to speak out of the abundance of that, man. If all you're listening to is F this, you know, corrupt communication, man. Motherfuckers sitting up there talking about, you know, one of the songs that came on, he was like, oh yeah, he's spiritually dead. Some Korean dude. It's like, yeah, something, I'm spiritually dead. Why would you want to listen to something like that? God never loved me. Well, you're right, Moab. God ain't really loving you like that. He ain't hating you like he hate Esau, but he don't love you like that. But still, man, you know, we should not be listening to that. We should be focused on these scriptures, man. These law, statutes, and commandments, man. And not corrupting our minds with the things in this world, man. Getting all in that spirit, using her pajamas and dancing. You dancing like David did for the Most High, for these demons. Anyway, with that, man, I say Shalom, man. You know, all praise and honor and glory go out first and foremost to Yahweh, Yahweh Shai. Yahweh being the Father, Yahweh Shai being the Son, and Y meaning and. So Yahweh, Yahweh Shai. And double honors to the apostles that rule well. And much respect and much love to you, brothers out there preaching the truth and sincerity, man. Shalom.